generally from there, and what I found now is it's all still the same thing. Like when you have that conversation, mm-hmm. and a lot of times just getting people to really kind of see where you're coming from, but also seeing where they're coming from, yeah. you know, and, oh. And getting them just to see like, hey, look, we might disagree, you know, like a parent mm-hmm. could have disagreed with you. They might've said, no, you should have suspended that kid.
Yeah.
Well, you know, maybe I could have, but this is why I felt this was yeah. the right way. But once again, you were engaging people in a very authentic conversation and being very real with them.
Yeah.
So it still alleviates that pressure that I like to say. That pressure comes from when you're not having that clear communication.
Yeah, and that social capital that, you know, I built in communities when I was administrator, I'm sure I know you would do the exact same thing. Every morning I'm outside greeting families, talking to kids, talking to, you know, parent in the hallway sees me and says, hey, can I talk to you for a second? I would never say, hey, you need to book an appointment. I was just like, hey, yeah, no problem. Come on in. If I'm free. And then when something goes wrong, then it was way easier to deal with. Right. But if that was the first time I ever interacted with that parent, they don't know anything about me. They don't know if I care about their kid. They don't like that 5 minute conversation could turn into hours and then calls the superintendent and all that other stuff. Right.
Can I chime in on that for a second?
Please, please.
Cause when you said that, it brought me to something and something that really kind of hit home for me as an administrator. So yeah. I think I made the comment earlier. My first administrative job was at a middle school. Mm-hmm. And it was actually in a different district. So the district that I had started in teaching, I actually went to a different district
yep.
to become middle school assistant principal. And, you know, I was 25. I think I had just yep. turned 25, 24, right. 20. So I was super young, you know, really young as an administrator, yep. right? So get to middle school, obviously start making those relationships, right? So I was there maybe 2 years. Yeah, I was there 2 years. Then I went back to grad school at UGA. So we were gone for several years and then I moved back and I ended up moving back in the district where I had started my administrative career at the time. Right. And I happened to then get a job at the high school up the street from the middle school where I used to be an assistant principal.
Right.
And those same little kids were now, half of them were like grown kids because some of them were looking me in the eye. And I'm about 6'3", 6'4", everybody. So some of those kids hit a huge growth spurt in those couple of years I was gone. But what was crazy was how those relationships then carried over
right
when I got back. Those same, Mr. Wood, like, oh, you haven't changed. I mean, you look a little older, your hairline. One mom just said, Miss Woods, it's starting to fade a little bit, honey. I'm like, yeah, you know, age is catching up to me, this stress that these kids giving me. But all joking aside, I remember it was such a surreal feeling because thinking about how some nuggets that you put years ago
right.
and laying the foundation is paying dividends several years later. Cause like I said, they hadn't seen totally. Me for what, 2, maybe 3 years and Rock coming the door. Oh, Mr. Woods. Hey, what's up? Oh, Mr. Woods up. Oh, we know how you feel about this. My bad. I mean, it just felt good just to kind of validate the impact of building those relationships.
It's like, if you know anything about stocks, ETFs, things like that, the earlier you invest, the more it pays off the longer. It's like compound interest. Like when you said that, basically those years going on over and over and over again, that compound interest, you know, accumulates very, very quickly.